Good morning friends. Today let us continue with our lecture on gravitation. So in the previous lectures we saw Newton's law of gravitation, right? The formula, what is Newton's universal law of gravitation? Every body in the universe attracts other bodies with a force which is directly proportional to the product of their masses and inversely proportional to the square of the distance between them. And we also saw what is weight, the gravitational force acting on the body. So we have got the formula how to find the gravitational force exerted by any planet, the acceleration due to gravity. And in the last part of yesterday's lecture, the previous lecture, we saw the equations of motion in which we replaced the displacement with the height and the acceleration by the g, acceleration due to gravity. So today we are going to try a few numericals first to understand the concept in very detail. So we have the first sum here. A car falls off a ledge and drops to the ground in 0.5 seconds. So what have we got here? We have got a ledge and a car falls off a ledge, okay? So the time taken to reach the ground, the time we have is t is equal to 0.5 seconds. And for convenience, we have taken g equal to 10 meter per second square. Actually, it is 9.8, for convenience, it is taken 10. Now you can see gravity is acting downwards. The car is falling downwards. So it is in the direction of the acceleration, so we will take g as positive. Now what are the things we have to find out here? What is the speed on striking the ground? Means here, while it reaches the ground, what is the speed here? So this will be the final velocity v. So how will we find? So we have got the first formula, v is equal to u plus gt. Now when the car was falling from here, the vertical velocity was 0, so we take u equal to 0. The car may be having a horizontal velocity, but it is having no vertical velocity, that was 0. So here the car is falling down, so we will take u equal to 0 meter per second. Now fill it, so you get v is equal to u is 0 plus gv to 10 and t is how much? 0.5 seconds, that is 5 upon 10. So this cuts and v is equal to 5 meter per second. So the velocity, final velocity when it is hitting the ground is 5 meter per second. Secondly, to find the average speed during this 0.5 seconds. So from here it fell to the ground here. So what is the average speed? Now how do we find the average velocity? We will write velocity, we will write, call it VAV. It is average. That is the initial velocity plus final velocity upon 2. So initial velocity was 0, final velocity was 5 meter per second upon 2. That will give us 2.5 meter per second. So when you have to find, here the velocity is changing. But for some numericals, if you have to take the average velocity, then we will have the average velocity is 2.5 meter per second. And third thing, how high is the ledge from the ground? Means, now we have to find out the height of the ledge. So which formula will we use? We have h equal to ut plus half gt square. We also have v square minus u square equal to 2gh. Now we have to find the h here. So we know the v, we know the u, we even know g. So we can find using this formula. Here we know the u, we know the t, we know g, we know t. So we can use either formula. Let us try with both. You know that h equal to u is 0. So this will become 0 plus half into 10. Right? G is 10. And T is 0.5. So 5 upon 10 into 5 upon 10. So 10 and 10 gets cut. So what do we get? We have it 25 upon 20 into 5 into 5. That is 125 upon 100 or 1.25 meter. Okay, that is the height. Let us verify by this formula. H will be equal to V square minus U square upon 2G. So V square is, V was 5, so 5 into 5, that is 25 upon 2 into G, that is 10, which gives us the very same answer, 1.25 meter. So you can use either formula to get the answer. Let us see one more numerical. Okay, so you have seen how we have changed the equations of motion. Now here you can see an object is thrown vertically upwards. So you are throwing the object upwards. Acceleration is downwards, body is going upwards. So this time we'll have G is equal to minus 9.8 meter per second square. Because the direction is opposite, remember. Now why I have not taken 10? In the previous time it was mentioned we could take it 10. Here it is not mentioned, so let us stick with 9.8. Now we know it reaches a height of 10 meter. The body thrown upward reaches a height of 10 meter. Okay? It's after reaching height of 10 meter, it will start to fall down again. So this is the maximum height it is reaching. So we have to find the velocity with which the object was thrown upwards, one thing, and the time taken by the object to reach the highest point, two things. So we have to find the velocity. Here u is not equal to 0. There was some velocity with which the object was thrown, so the object reached a height of 10 meters. So we have to find this initial velocity and also the time taken to reach the top. So which formula will we use here? We know V square minus U square equal to 2GH. So H is equal to V square minus U square upon 2G. What is V square? Now here V will be how much? When the body is reaching the top and then it is coming down from here, means for 1 second it will stop here. So here V will become 0. So 0 square is 0 minus U. That we have to find. Okay, sorry, we don't have to find the H here, I'll rub it off, we have to find the, we have to find U. So I will change the formula to, we'll change the formula to V square plus 2GH equal to U square. I have changed U on this side and this I should put here minus, sorry. This will not be plus, that will be a minus. Okay. This will put a minus. Now V square is 0. So 0 minus 2. G is minus 9.8. Height is 10 equal to U square. So minus and minus will get cut. So 19.6 into 10, it is 196 equal to U square. So U is equal to square root of 196, that is 14. So U is equal to 14 meter per second. So that was the initial velocity, 14 meter per second, by which the object was thrown. And now we'll find the time taken to reach the highest point. Which formula will we use? V is equal to U plus GP. So T is equal to V minus U upon G. You have to rearrange. So V minus U and G comes down. So T is equal to V was 0 minus U. U we got 14 upon G. G is minus 9.8. So we get 14 upon 9.8. So how much is that? 140 upon 98. So we have 14, 7 is the 98, 14 tens are, so 10 upon 7, you can do your calculation and see what is the answer you get. So let us calculate and see. 10, 7, 1 is the 7, 3.0, 7, 4 is the 28, 2, 7, 2 is the 14, so almost 1.42 seconds is the answer. Okay, so we have learned how to use the equations of motion during the vertical height now. When the body is dropped from a top building or a body is thrown upward. We have kept it very simple here and not made it complex. Okay, initially we saw that the body in the previous chapter, the car is going on a horizontal road and so on. Here we have changed it to vertical. And whenever a body is falling towards the ground or going away from the ground, there is always a force, the earth's gravitational force acting on the body. So it will either go in the upward or the downward direction. When it is falling downward with the acceleration, we take g positive, and when it is going upward against the acceleration, we take the g negative. Now these are very simple sums because we have not taken any motion other than the horizontal or vertical motion. But you know, in real life we have motion which is a combination of both horizontal and vertical, but that we are not going to do in this standard. Okay, that you will have for the future. Now the next topic we have is mass. What is mass? So the definition of mass is, mass is the amount of matter contained in a body. So all the bodies we know about, the solid, liquid and gas. Okay, we also have plasma and Bose expansion condensate, but we stick to solid, liquid and gas. All the objects have got some amount of matter in the body, which is called its mass. And we have learned previously that the mass of an object is the measure of its inertia. If you remember, what is inertia? It is the tendency of the body to resist the change in state. So if a body has got more mass, it has got more inertia. So mass of an object is the measure of its inertia. Now, mass is the amount of matter contained in the body, means the matter, when you do not take out any matter from the body or do not add any matter to the body, then the mass of the body will not change. So if you take your mobile phone from one place to another and you do not remove its cover or its battery, just keep it as it is, then the mass of that object should remain the same. A piece of iron taken anywhere around will not change in mass because you are not adding anything to it, neither removing anything from it. But if dust settles on it or it gets rusted, only then the mass will change. So the mass remains the same when the object remains the same. So wherever you take the mass, whether it is on the earth, you take it to the moon, you take it to the outer space, you take it deep inside the ocean, wherever, the mass of an object is constant. So the mass does not change from place to place. And you can understand the reason why it does not change. Because mass is the amount of matter in the body. Until you do not remove anything from that body or do not add anything to the body, the mass, which should remain the same. So mass we know is measured in kg. Remember, the mass is measured in kg. So mass is the amount of matter contained in a body. Next is weight. So what is weight? Weight is the gravitational force acting on a body. Now we know, what is the formula of force? Force is mass into acceleration, that we have learned. So what is weight then? The force of attraction of the earth on an object, because the earth attracts every object towards its center. So this force of attraction is known as weight of the object, and weight is denoted by the letter W. Now don't get confused with W, because W will see a lot of times, but here weight is indicated, denoted by W. So force, The gravitational force, we'll call it weight now, that is W is equal to M and A becomes G, whose value we already saw is 9.8 meter per second square. So weight is the gravitational force acting on the body. So as weight is the object of the force which is attracted towards the earth, the SI unit of weight is the same as that of force. So remember, the SI unit of mass was kg, the SI unit of weight will be the unit of force. What is the unit of force? Newton. So remember that weight is always measured in Newton, mass is measured in kg. Usually we say my weight is 60 kg, but that is not the weight, that is the mass 60 kg. The weight has to be measured in Newton. So what we use in the common language is not the language of physics. Physics is very precise when you say mass and when you say weight. So when you say mass, it is in kg. When you say weight, it is, should be in Newton. Now, weight is the force which is acting vertically downwards, means towards the center of the earth. So it has both got magnitude and direction, and hence weight is a vector quantity. We know what a vector quantity is, it needs both magnitude and direction. So again, what is mass? Is the amount of matter contained in the body. What is weight? It is a gravitational force acting on the body. So if you are asked a question, differentiate between mass and weight, or give the differences between mass and weight, how many points will you write down? The first point to write down is the definition. Mass is the amount of matter contained in the body. Weight is the gravitational force acting on the body. Second, you can write, the mass is constant, means it remains same everywhere. Weight changes according to the acceleration of gravity, because you can see W equal to M into G. M will not change, but if the G changes, means you take it to the moon, the G changes. If you take it to Jupiter, the G will change. So weight will change according to the acceleration of gravity. Third point, mass is a scalar quantity, weight is a vector quantity. And fourth point, mass is measured in kg and weight is measured in Newton. Okay, so now we have done something before and I am repeating this. We saw weight is equal to mass into g, okay? And we took g on the earth to be 9.8 meter per second square, considering the earth is uniform everywhere. But we saw in the previous lecture, the earth is not a perfect sphere. It is flat at the poles and bulging at the equator. I showed you yesterday. So it is slightly bulging at the equator, but slightly flat at the poles, something like an orange. So if you see this radius here, polar radius is smaller while the equatorial radius is bigger. Re is greater than Rp. Now why we see this in the formula of the gravitational force? We saw it is capital G M into M upon R. Now this R, so if the radius is more, then the gravitational force will be less. If the radius is less, the gravitational force will be more. So as the radius of the earth increases from poles to the equator, the value of G becomes greater at the poles than at the equator. So because the equatorial radius is more, the value of G is less. And because the radius at the poles is less, the value of G is more. So G at the poles is more than G at the equator. And that is why a body weighs more at the poles than at the equator. So the mass of the body will remain the same everywhere, but when you take a body from the equator to the pole, it will be more, it will weigh more. The mass will remain the same, but it will weigh more. Now let us compare the weight of an object on the moon. Again we know weight equal to mass into acceleration to gravity. Now this gravity depends upon the mass of the moon and the radius of the moon. So the weight of an object on the moon is the force with which the moon attracts the object. Like I told you, the mass of the moon is less than the earth, the radius of the moon is less than the earth. So it will have lesser, the object will weigh lesser. Because of lesser force of attraction, the same object will weigh less on the moon. So how do we calculate? Let us say the mass of an object is m. Now again we use the word mass here, means this m will remain same on the earth, remain same on the moon. And the weight of the moon we take wm. Sorry, we should not say weight, we should say again here, it is not the weight, it is the mass. Okay, we are calculating the weight on the moon, sorry. Here we are trying to calculate, the weight on the moon. So we'll call it wm. How will we calculate? We have to know the mass of the moon and the radius of the moon. So by using the universal law of gravitation, the weight on the moon is equal to g, product of the mass of the moon into mass of the body upon square of radius of the moon. Now since the formula is the same, let us compare. Let us compare the weight on the So gravitational force of an object is given by this formula. Now for comparison, I have got the Earth, whose mass is 5.9 into 10 raised to 24 kg, radius is 6.37 into 10 raised to 6 meter. The mass of the moon is 7.36 into 10 raised to 22 kg and the radius is 1.74 into 10 raised to 6. Now taken the weight of the moon and weight of the Earth and comparing the weight of the moon to the weight of the Earth, writing the formula, the g and the g will get cut, the m and the m will get cut. So what we have, mass of the moon, that is 7.36 into 10 raised to 22 upon radius of the moon, that is 1.74 into 1.74 into 10 raised to 6 and 6 becomes 12, upon mass of the Earth, 5.98 into 10 raised to 24 upon 6.37 into 6.37 into 10 raised to 12. This 10 raised to 12 and 10 raised to 12 gets cut. The 10 raised to 24 here it is. So this gets cut and 10 raised to 2 remains. So that we will have, this will become 7.37, 1.74 into 1.74 is almost equal to 2.431 upon 5.98 upon 6.37 is 1.474 into 10 raised to 1. So the value will be almost 0.165 or approximately equal to 1 by 6. So the object on the moon weighs 1/6 of the weight on the Earth. Means, let us say the weight on the Earth is 60 kg. Then on the moon, the object will only weigh 10 kg because the weight on the moon is 1/6 the weight on the Earth. So the same question is asked here, mass of an object is 10 kg. What is the weight on the Earth? W equal to m into g. M is given 10, g is 9.8 meter per second square. So the answer will be 98 Newton. So object weighing 10 kg, the mass, not weighing, sorry, when the mass of the object is 10 kg, the weight on the Earth is 98 Newton. But remember, we have taken this 9.8 as a constant on the Earth, it is not. If you weigh on the equator and if you weigh on the poles, there will be a difference in the weights. An object weighs 10 Newton when measured on the surface of the Earth. What would the weight be on the surface of the moon? So what we had seen, weight of the moon upon weight of the Earth was almost 1/6 in this ratio. So weight on the moon upon 10 is almost equal to 1 upon 6. So we'll write equal to here. So weight on the moon is 10 upon 6, or it is almost equal to 1.67 Newton. Okay, so I'm not going to continue further because these topics are slightly to be understood. So we take it turn by turn. Again, what did we revise today? What have we done for today? We did a few numericals on the equations of motion. Remember the equations v is equal to u plus gt, s equal to ut plus half gt square, v square minus u square equal to 2gx. In the equations of motion, we have replaced the displacement with the height and the acceleration of gravity by g. Okay, then we saw what is mass and what is weight. We saw the differences between mass and weight. So remember, there are 4 points. The question can be asked for 2 marks. Then we started to compare the weight of the moon and the weight of the earth, and how we can find the weight of an object on different planets also. So today's topic is only about weight and mass. So understand the difference thoroughly. These are the concepts of physics. If you understand each and every concept in detail, only then you'll understand the physics properly. So this is enough for today. I'm going to end here. Kindly revise it well. Thank you.